All right, so a couple of my friends have been doing this, and I really want to do Abby's popular opinions tag, so I figure I should do the unpopular opinions book tag. I don't think anyone's tagged me. This is just one of those evergreen tags that have always been going around BookTube, although I'll have the original link down below. It was done by the Book Archer. So I will link that down in the description if you want to see the original tag, and these are the prompts I'm pulling from. And just keep in mind, these are unpopular opinions, which means not fact, as in not coming for you. These are not personal attacks on you and your favorite books. These are just my opinions based off my experiences. And yeah, we'll see. I try really hard not to be like super negative, but there are some stuff on this list that I just like really don't like. So we will see what happens in this video, but let's go. Number one, a popular book or series that you didn't like. We got a few. So let's start with one of the more recent ones. I really didn't get on with Lonesome Dove by Larry McMurtry. This is a beloved historical fiction. If you go on Goodreads, it has an absurdly high rating. It's actually my boyfriend's, like, one of his favorite books ever. And I read it and it just, I'm trying to think of what I gained from reading that book. And there really wasn't a lot. It was 800 pages. I didn't love that many of the characters. The characters I did like were done so dirty. I mean, one thing I guess I didn't hate is that it's a very, I feel, closer to accurate, non-glorifying portrayal of the West in America in the 1800s. But like, it's still like, I guess I would have rather have read a nonfiction if that's what I was going for. I don't really know what I expected from that book, but it was very much not for me. Another one that I feel is like blasphemy is I Don't Like Neverwhere by Neil Gaiman. I did finally read that in college. It took me three times over the course of like 7 years to pick up and finish that book. It's only like 300 pages. I still to this day do not know what happened or what it's about. It was just boring. It was dreadfully boring for me. I didn't understand it. I think now that I've been around, maybe a TV show happened first and this kind of came after it and they were both created by Neil Gaiman. I could be really wrong. I think a TV show could be better. I just found the main protagonists very boring. I didn't find the situation interesting, although it should have been interesting. Like, that's why I bought it. I wanted to like it. So that one is a popular one, like so popular, and I don't get it. Another one is Night Angel, that whole trilogy by Brent Weeks. I actually do like the Lightbringer series. Might talk about it in a bit. But I did not get on with Night Angel. It took me way too long to read that trilogy. I didn't like any of the plot twists. I didn't like the tropes because the tropes were just like so overdone and didn't bring anything new. Or even if they'd stayed exactly the same, I just didn't like the characters and I didn't like the writing. So I really didn't like that trilogy. And I know people really like that one. I think it's popular because Goodreads has it as popular, but I don't hear a lot of people on BookTube talking about it. But I do not like The Reckoners by Brandon Sanderson. The more I think about that series, the angrier I get. And you can see my shelves. I love Brandon Sanderson, auto-buy author. The Reckoners series makes me angry when I remember the time I put into it. Because I never got along with David as the main character. He's the main point of view, it's in first person. And I kept reading it because I'm like, Sanderson always comes through. The ending will be worth it. And in my opinion, was not worth it. Another popular series that I just like did not like, and it wasn't even like a pleasure read did not like, was I think it's the Mortal Instruments. It's the City of Bones, City of Glass. I don't know. It's all those, it's the weird half-cropped torso books. I don't know. I read them in high school, so I read them as the age group one was supposed to read them. And there was, if you've read them, you know the trope that happens with the whole love triangle thing. Like, and it's not the love triangle that makes me upset. It's the part of the love romance. There's a trope element put in, and I was angry. I was like, I did not feel like I needed to be put through that emotional turmoil. And everyone was just too angsty, even for me. And I read it at my like angstiest point in my life. So if there was a time for that series to have connected with me, it would have been then. So I didn't like that one. Another one that I'll mention is The Testaments by Margaret Atwood. I do actually have a review for this one on the channel. I did not like this book. I mainly don't like it because of its popularity. It won a very prestigious literary fiction award. That book is not very good literary fiction. It is, I guess, fine popular fiction. There's nothing against that. It was a perfectly fine book. But if you compare it to the other book that won that award that year that had to be shared the prize with, made me angry. So I don't like that popular book, but I don't think a lot of people on BookTube like The Testaments, but I just really didn't like it. Number two, a popular book or series that everyone else seems to hate, but you love. So this is interesting because I did notice when I joined BookTube that a lot of people seem to dislike Uprooted by Naomi Novik. I think that one's actually right behind me. And I love this book. I have read it twice now, and the first time I read it in like 2 days. I read it so quickly. It completely consumed me. I love this book. Now, I've heard all the complaints. I think they're valid complaints. Obviously, if you don't like a main character, you might not like the book. I do think there are some weird elements of the romance, but I didn't hate them as much as other people. So I don't know. I really liked Uprooted. I actually don't like its, not sequel, but the next book, Spinning Silver. I didn't like that one as much. I also really like the Lightbringer series by Brent Weeks. I know I talked about Night Angel earlier in the tag and how I really didn't get along with it, but I really like the Lightbringer series. I think it has amazing plot twists and action, and it's very engaging. I like the magic. I've read the whole thing and I am good with where it ended up. I mean, there were some things in the last book that I was like, eh, I wish you'd done something different. Like, I think the fourth book's my favorite, but I do hear the complaints and I do think they're valid. He definitely is an author who over-sexualizes everyone. So I don't think it's actually one of those book series where it's like a male gaze problem. There's just actually a lot of sexual gazing at people. And I do think there is like internalized fat phobia by one of the main characters. But having read the whole series, I really like what was done with that. Like, obviously that's not like a great place, but I don't think the author thinks that's a great place to be either. But I can see why maybe you don't want to read that. I get that. But I really like it. I thought it was a really fun time. That's why I have them all. So those are my answers for this one. Three, a love triangle where the main character ended up with the person you did not want them to end up with, or an OTP that you don't like. First of all, I'm old, and I think OTP means one true pairing, but I don't know. And honestly, it's been so long since I've actually like super been invested with things like this. For me, I think I'm pretty basic. I don't like Hermione and Ron, like, at all. And as someone who grew up, like, very hyper-identifying with Hermione, I'm just like, you should have been with Harry. Although, I will say, in the books, I'm actually okay with Harry and Ginny, because I think Ginny in the books, really solid character. I don't mind that. But Hermione was done dirty being put with, like, Ron. Ron is just, like, not my favorite. I'll also say that I was definitely Team Jacob back in the Twilight phase of life, you know, read those in high school, and yeah, I was never big on Edward then, and I'm not big on him now, and like, there's all problems in all of the relationships there, but I was definitely like, if I was in Bella's position, would have chosen Jacob. Four, a popular book genre that you hardly reach for. This is easy. This is thrillers and horrors. I never pick these up. I am trying to. I have some horrors on my shelf back here. Both of them I think are by Victor Lavelle. So I do want to pick up some, but I'm just a little worried. I like when things are more creepy and unsettling, which might actually be horror, but I just have still not picked up that many. And I feel like with thrillers, I actually don't mind when I read a thriller in one of my other genres, like a fantasy thriller or a sci-fi thriller. But even when I read that subgenre of one of my primary genres, it's never a book that stays with me, which means it's fine, but it's like I have to be in a very specific mood to want that type of like pleasure reading experience, if that makes sense, because they're not very rereadable for me. So that's definitely like a part of reading that I do not reach for. Number five, a popular or beloved character that you do not like. Well, I guess I already talked about how I don't like Ron Weasley. It's true. And I guess another Harry Potter character that as I grow up, I dislike more and more, and that's like Dumbledore. I'm just like, you embody so many tropes I don't like, and like, you're supposed to be the adult. You're not acting like an adult. It's just like, as I get older and I think about it, it's just like, this plan does not make sense. I also have a few other ones. Oh, basically, for some reason, except for Bryce in Crescent City or House of Earth and Blood, I do not get along with any of Sarah J. Maas's main characters. Like, I still like the books. It doesn't completely detract, which you think it would, because I think almost all of them are first-person point of view. But, like, Feyre, she's not it for me, and I don't even remember the main character's name in Throne of Glass. I think Selena or something. I don't like her. They're just, like, I don't know, I don't get along with any of them, but I still like the books, and obviously those are extremely popular series, so I assume a lot of people like those characters, or maybe this is not an unpopular opinion. I would also say that I have a rough time with a lot of the Wheel of Time main characters. I have now read 5 Wheel of Time books, and I know a lot still to come. There's still 9 novels and a short story, not a short story, a novella. So I know there's a lot more room for development, but I've also spent like 5,000 pages with some of these characters and they haven't developed yet. And I'm like, goodness, it's been like over a year in the time of the book. The world is ending. Develop. Like... Mainly, a lot of them have this a very similar flaw of pride and miscommunication, and there's a lot of stubbornness, and it's driving me up the wall, a lot of these tendencies. So there's just, I think, one that comes to mind that I feel like I will change my mind on. If I think a few of them is Nynaeve and Matt. I've actually already come around a little bit with Rand. I did not like Rand for a long time. I do like Perrin, but I've been told my opinions on Perrin will change. And I currently like Elaine, which I hear also those will change in probably a negative way. So this will probably always be an answer, that there are characters in Wheel of Time that people love that I do not understand. I think that's part of it. It's not like I like or dislike them. I do not get them. I do not understand this thought process, because like Nynaeve, she's like my age. She's like in her mid-20s, late 20s, and she's acting ridiculous. Like if I met her in real life and had to do a group project with her, I'd be the one boxing her ears. That's a phrase she uses like a million times. I don't even know what that means. I think it means hitting someone upside the head. I have no idea. No idea. And like I said, I don't actually think she's a bad character to have in a book, but goodness, I'm very excited for her to develop already. Number 6, a popular author that you can't seem to get into. Oh, there's a few. There's a few. I think the first one so far is Stephen King, which I know one of my subscribers, Travis, loves Stephen King. And I am sorry, I'm still going to keep trying here and there. Like, none of these actually are authors I've given up on. It's just that I've read a few of their works, like usually 3 to 5, and it's like, I don't get it. Stephen King's definitely one of those. I just think his prose style doesn't translate always for my brain. I don't usually connect with his characters, and then we all know about his endings. And if you've watched my books preferences video, I'm big on endings. So yeah, so there's Stephen King. Neil Gaiman, I have read almost all of his full-length novels. I don't really like any of them. I think they're all good, but I've read American Gods, I've read Neverwhere, I've read Stardust. I have read I like his novellas and short stories and TV shows. So the, is it The Girl at the End of the Lane or The Ocean at the End of the Lane? I like that one. And I haven't read Anasazi Boys because I didn't really like American Gods, and I know it's related to that. I don't know, I just don't get along with his writing very much, but I love his ideas. Like, I think his ideas are really cool. So I like when he does like novellas and TV shows so I can like get those ideas. I actually still want to consume Coraline because I think it's like the type of creepy horror that I would like. So he's one. Another one that actually I haven't tried much, but I do not feel the need, is Mark Lawrence. I've read or tried to read Prince of Thorns. It just bored me, and none of the premises of his other books really interest me. And another one that I'm not giving up on, still going to continue reading, is Joe Abercrombie. I have read The First Law twice now, once audio, once physical, and I like them well enough, but I don't get, when people say how much they love them, I can't relate to that emotion. And I'm just like, I want to relate to that emotion. Like, yes, this character work is good. Yes, this is good writing. But like the emotions and the connections you have to this work, I don't have, and it bothers me. So I still need to continue. I need to read the standalones and then the new trilogy while the First Law world is fresh in my mind. That was the whole point of rereading them last year. So that's just another author to add to this list. But probably the big two are Neil Gaiman and Stephen King. Number 7, a popular book trope that you're tired of seeing. Well, I don't know, if you've been here for a long time, you probably know this one. If not, here we go. I hate magic leaving the world. I don't like it. I'm done with it. Like, I think it was cool when it was first done by Tolkien, or maybe it was done another time, but I don't know, in modern fantasy, obviously first done by him, but I'm so done with it. I don't want magic to be leaving the world. I want there to be magic. That's the whole point of me picking up the fantasy book. I want there to be magic. The world can be ending. That's fine. I love World's Ending. Mistborn, Stormlight Archives, the Broken Earth Trilogy. I love dying Earth worlds. I just don't want the magic to be going away. You know, I don't know. It's like this thing that a lot of fantasy authors have just done for so long, and I'm just so over it. And it always, and then like in Wheel of Time, it's working out that like magic has been decreasing forever, but we've suddenly are with our cast who are more powerful than people have seen since, I think, the Second Age. I don't know. And I'm just like, well, this is kind of cool, because at least I'm following the people who have magic. But still in the back of my head, I'm like, magic's leaving the world again. And I don't like it. I also despise, like most people, the miscommunication trope. I hate miscommunications in my own life. Not a fan. It's bad. But I despise it in a story, especially if it doesn't make sense. Especially if I feel like, as a reader, that it's a plot device. That it's like, this miscommunication's here because if we put this here, then this thing will happen. And I'm like, oh, I hate it. It's just like the type of dramatic irony that frustrates me to no end. Now, if it makes sense, I'm cool with it. Like, there are situations where it can make sense. But when it's not done well, it's just a trope that will, it will pull me from the story, and not in a good way. Number 8, a popular series that you have no interest in reading. I have a few, and actually one of them, two of them actually, are kind of cheats. Actually, all three of them are kind of cheats, but like, I've attempted all of these series and I have no interest in ever picking them up again or pursuing them. One of them is The Chronicles of Narnia, not because I didn't like The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. I even liked The Magician's Nephew, but I tried to read some of the other ones when I was of the age, like when I was the right age to read these books. I mean, not that it's a problem reading them as an adult, but I was a middle grader. I was, in theory, the target audience. And I just didn't get along with it. And then now as an adult, it's like, I don't have the nostalgia attachment. Maybe if I have kids and they pick this up from the library and they want to read it, I would read it to them and spend time with them. I have nothing against it, but like as an adult for my own pleasure reading experience, it's just not something I'm going to gravitate towards. Also, the Shannara series, I actually have read, they're prequels, but they're written after the original trilogy. I can't remember the names of them, there'll be an image here, but I actually read that entire trilogy and I really liked it because it was kind of like a post-apocalyptic magic's coming back into the world sort of take on how we get to Shannara, because Shannara, like a lot of the fantasy from like the 80s, is playing with our Earth in some way, like either our present-day Earth is before or after the fantasy happening. And so I liked that trilogy, but I had no interest in pursuing the fantasy that he did for Shannara because it felt like it was going to be very like elves and dwarves and kind of standard tropes that like is not why I read fantasy. It's not like my thing. I do have a like meet the fantasy reader tag if you want to know like more about why I love fantasy and why I read it. And some of the more classic races and tropes, although they are not turnoffs for me completely, they're not what make me love the genre, and so I think that's why I've just been avoiding a lot of classics 80s fantasy, and particularly sort of Shannara. I did actually own a bind-up of that trilogy for like 5 years, and I never touched it. And the last one, I did read the first book, and that's The Black Company. I don't know if it's a trilogy or a saga or whatever. That book was not it for me, and I thought at first it was because I read it at the wrong time. Like, I read it on vacation, and I wasn't mentally in a space to be just thrown in the middle of things, because that's a book that just throws you in the middle. And I also hadn't read other books that did that and have gotten better at consuming that type of story. But then I saw a bunch of my friends who are all variously experienced in reading like that, have very mediocre experiences, and although they tell me the other books are better, I'm just like, eh, I don't really need to see the origins of Grimdark. I've got other series that are challenging to take up my time, like Malazan. Like, that one has me at least excited because it does things that I think are cool. Like, if you can confuse me in a way that makes me feel like it's cool, at least I'm cool. But I didn't get any of that from Black Company when I read it. Number 9, the saying goes, the book is always better than the movie, but what movie or TV show adaptation do you prefer more than the book? Stardust. This goes back to Neil Gaiman. I have some issues with this author for some reason. I don't know why. But Stardust the movie is like this great fantasy romantic comedy. And the book, its romantic and comedic elements do not land for me, which bothers me because I love that movie because it's like a fantasy romantic comedy. Like, I love it so much. And the book, I just like, I owned it at one point and it is, I don't know when I got rid of it, but it is not around. anymore. Another one I'd say is the Witcher series. I would say that right now the season we have is based off the first two books, and actually I would say that's about equal. Like, I think they complement each other well because the short stories are primarily Geralt's perspective, and the show gets to show you Yennefer and Ciri, and it has this really cool non-linear thing going on, and I think it's actually a really good two sides of the same coin. But as I've read the Witcher novels, I've read the first three, so Blood of Elves, Time of Contempt, Baptism of Fire, I think the show is going to continue to do a better job at giving me what I want, which is Geralt. Like, I don't think they're going to make the mistake that Sapkowski made and hide Henry Cavill from me. Like, I don't think that's what they're going to do. I mean, if you're paying him, you're putting him on screen. So I think my issues with the books are going to be very solved with the TV show as we get into the main meat of the plot in the novels as the show continues on Netflix. And the last one I'll say are the Lord of the Rings movies. I actually don't think this is a hot take. I think a lot of people really love the movies and will rewatch those movies all the time more than they reread the books. I have rewatched those movies. I have read the books. I actually don't love either one a lot. I think they're both great. They're good to great stuff. But I do think if you had to, you know, if I had to choose between reading it again or watching it again, I'd watch it. I think it really holds up. It has really pretty scenes. And I also, I mean, just personally as a fantasy lover, I really appreciate what Lord of the Rings has done for the genre, both in the written form and the visual medium form. Like, it's a very essential series, regardless of my personal experiences with it. But I do think I prefer the movie to the books for that one. So that's this tag. I actually do not know how many of my friends have and have not done it since I said this was an evergreen tag. But feel free, if you're watching this, tag yourself. Feel free to say I tagged you. I just wanted to get this off my chest. I haven't done this since starting my channel. And I feel like, as Abby says, it's good to get it out early. So you know where I stand. And remember, they're all opinions, which means not facts, and that's all good. But that's it for this one. I don't know what emoji to have you guys put down below. If you want to answer any of these questions, feel free to leave that in the comments, or you can go to my Discord and we can chat about it over there. I love talking to people about anything, and if you want an emoji, like you don't have the spoons for a comment, I do not know. Leave like the angry emoji, you know, like the red face one, or I guess sometimes it's purple. But yeah, the angry emoji, I think that's a funny one. I like using that one. And otherwise, like if you liked it, subscribe if you want to, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.